New at 10, several emergency life-saving stations equipped with ring buoys will be unveiled tomorrow. They're going to be installed at beaches right there along the San Mateo County coast to help prevent drownings. As KTVU's Asna Smith reports, this idea came about from the tragic death of a boy from Fremont.
These are the most current version.
These new signs and ring buoys, part of life-saving stations at some Bay Area beaches. Eric Jones, the founder of nonprofit Sea Valor, knows the unique dangers of sneaker waves.
From a very young age, I was taught by my parents, you know, you never turn your back on the ocean because it's just unpredictable.
But many beach visitors don't know the risks. Jones helped with the search of 12-year-old Aruna Pruthi of Fremont. The seventh grader swept out to sea back in January, pulled in by a sneaker wave playing on Cal Ranch State Beach.
It was something we never imagined would happen on a bright, sunny day at the beach.
For 15 minutes, Aruni's family and other beachgoers watched as Aruni tried to swim. Human chains were formed, items like beach tents were thrown. Nothing was able to bring him back.
All the people on that beach that day were helpless, standing there and watching it happen. It's really tough.
I mean, it's a lifelong grief, so we may not be able to recover from it, but we just have to move forward.
10 months later, the Rune Foundation, along with Sea Valor Nonprofit, now raising awareness about beach hazards. With these stations, complete with a triangular sign that say danger in 12 different languages, an informational sign noting how many people have died from sneaker waves.
This is a decal that can be, hopefully over the years, dropped.
And the most important component, a life ring with 100 feet of rope attached.
The idea is that hopefully somebody will grab one of these rings and throw them to the person in distress instead of just jumping in themselves.
Privately funded and sponsored, first installed at Mavericks Beach and two at Surfers Beach. Aruni's family believes if there was a station like this that day, their son would be home.
All I know is if someone else would have put it there, they could have saved my son's life, so why not me doing it for someone else's life?
This project will serve as a pilot program. The hope is that it will expand to other areas along the California coastline once permits are secured. The ribbon cutting is tomorrow morning. At Pillar Point Harbor, I'm Azit Smith, KTVU Fox 2 News.